Welcome back, folks. Dow off 33, NASDAQ off 18, S&P's off 5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Teddy Kekstadt, as we do each and every Wednesday at 40 past the hour. You can check out Teddy every trading day, folks, at his website, which is forex-trading-unlocked.com. That's forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy Kekstadt, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, guys. How are you today?
Morning, Teddy.
Well, we got some movement out here, man. That pound has picked its head up. The euro looks like it's picking its head up.
Yeah, we got some bulls going on over in Europe in front of the meetings that are going on tomorrow and Friday. So for your viewers, I don't know if they're aware of obviously everyone's aware of the Brexit situation that's going on, but the European Council on Brexit is meeting tomorrow and Friday. So we're probably not going to see very much action for the rest of today's session going into Friday in the euro and the pound right now, I would think.
Okay.
So this was the lead up to all the fun.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, the euro and the pound have both been rallying very nicely. If you look at the daily chart, we had that buy signal a couple weeks ago. And right where the market is right now, it's pretty much into our target area from that initial buy signal from that low. Oh. So right now, I think we're in a really good situation where regardless of how the meeting comes out, we'll probably see just a slight pullback in the euro-US dollar, a little consolidation, because you have almost an upside-down head and shoulders forming. If you look at that current big low on the euro-US dollar chart, it's like the head for a head and shoulders forming up right now. And then we have the pound-US dollar, which obviously has been very strong, especially over the past couple weeks. The weekly chart, actually, it's strong today. It's hovering below its highs and stuff. But the last week, it was an explosive week. So we know that the range in the pound, when it starts to move, can get very extreme. And it looks like it definitely, a lot of bulls are heading into this meeting. So we'll see what happens. But I think you're going to see digestion for the next couple days. I don't think there's going to be much more of a swing trade left in it.
Well, you know what's interesting is that they seem to both be moving up. I mean, you know, together, which is kind of cool, actually. You know what I mean?
It's the first time in a while this year, right, Tom?
Yeah. Yeah. You know, so it's like, because it almost looked like the pounds could go to a dollar, and not the pound, the euro. Almost looked like the euro could go to a dollar at a certain point. But
hey, it almost looked like the pound, too, on that trend, man. Seriously. There was no end in sight.
We'll see. We have
a little bit of dollar weakness creeping in. As far as the currencies are going, you have the pound U.S. dollar, the euro U.S. dollar that are strong. You have the U.S. dollar yen right now that's fledgling. It was lower earlier today. Now it's kind of flat underneath hot new move highs that it set yesterday. You have the U.S. dollar Swiss also that has fallen short of parity the last few sessions and is a little bit right before we got on the air was lower. So I'm not sure where it's at right now. So I think that the dollar index right now obviously is on a little bit of a pause, but we might be starting to see a little bit of a turn where we might start to see the dollar index pull back and start to see a little bit more strength in these other currencies.
Yes. Hey, what do you think about the yen? It looks like the yen, I mean, you know, it's coming into that downdraft from, what, August 1st. But if it gets by that downdraft, man, that could basically get some juice, right?
Right. Well, what's interesting is the recent highs that it set over the past few sessions. Remember last week when we were talking about how those highs had gotten rejected and the market was actually a little sluggish.
Yes.
Now, all of a sudden, it made this lower move low, and it took out the highs for the past few weeks.
Right.
That's a very positive signal. But then also, if you look at the trend, the U.S. dollar yen's been rallying basically for a couple months now. I think we might be seeing, now, if the dollar index starts to weaken, we may see now this is a little bit of a toppy area for the U.S. dollar yen and start to see a little bit of a retracement back to lower levels. I think today's close is big. If you look at how we haven't made a higher move high yet, if the market settles a little bit lower, like if it starts to look like where it was a few hours ago, that's a short-term sell signal. And especially if we get a close that's lower today and another lower close tomorrow, that would set off a nice sell pattern that we probably would see the market trend lower for the next week or so.
Good. Because right now, that thing, looks to me, it doesn't look to me, but we know where it is. I mean, if that busts this top side, man, the gold market will get smoked. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like, yeah, interesting.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I think that the bulls, as aggressive as they've been for the U.S. dollar yen over the past week especially, I I think this is an exhaustion gap. I think you're going to start to see it fall apart.
Right.
Is that why? So what we're talking about, folks, the why buy was an extraordinary move on the 1st of August. Yeah. We went from 109 to 107.
It's huge action everywhere on there, right? That's when bonds took off, everything, but that's quite a bar on that yen.
Yeah.
Right. And remember, we're done with the interest rate stuff right now for a little bit. No one's really concerned about central banks right now.
Right.
Yeah. Pretty wild. So we're going to be back to the European Union, the Brexit, the pound. I guess that the pound and the euro are going to be basically the movers out here, right?
Absolutely. Well, I think they're going to be movers come Friday, unless there's, or probably next week, because I don't think we're going to get a lot of noise out of this council meeting unless they start to really spark headlines, you know. But I think the Swiss, you could see a little swell off. The yen, especially, like I said, if we get a negative close today. Now, for your U.S. dollar Canada traders, that market has been wedging. It's kind of stuck in the mid, like the lower part of a dollar and a half range. I wouldn't have very much expectations for that market either. I think it's going to probably be a little bit positive to neutral over the next week or so, but not much of a swing trade going there. But yes, after the next couple of days, I think we'll start to see some action. But I think range traders are going to be the ones that are going to be making the money over the next 24 to 48 hours.
Yeah, and you know, we haven't had, like, I mean, last week there was some really fast movement there, but we haven't had, like, really fast movement in the currency markets for a while, right?
No, we haven't. We've had some nice trends. Individual markets on a daily basis, some have had some moves, like the pound. The pound has had aggressive rallies over the past couple weeks when the other currencies were really quiet. If you look at the rally from the euro US dollar versus the pound, there's not much of a movement on the euro. It's gone up, but it's still basically really, it's right now around that 110 area, but 108.80 is just, you know, it's a buck and a half away, you know? But with the pound, look at how it's moved in the past 2 weeks. It's taken out like five handles. That's a big aggressive move in basically a week, actually, of trading.
Right. Yeah. And, you know, what does happen with the pound, folks, okay, I mean, this thing has got killed in the last 2.5 years. It's very unusual that the pound is this low. I mean, in the context of 20 or 30 years.
It's very unusual the country exits the European Union.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. There's no doubt.
Yeah.
Funny, right?
Interesting times we live in right now.
I'll tell you, man.
You know what I think is going to get interesting is after this meeting, guys, because we're right now, we're 16 days or 15 days away from the actual Brexit date. With the way it's looking right now, there's some pretty big issues that they're talking about as far as traveling. You know, like, you're going to be able to travel between the UK and the EU, but you're not going to be able to move to the UK after January 1 very easily at all.
Yeah, it's going to change a lot, man. That's what happens. Yeah.
So we'll see. It's going to get interesting, right, guys?
Oh, that's for sure.
Teddy, you have a great week, safe week, and of course, we look forward to speaking to next Wednesday.
Sounds great, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for the update, Teddy.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back.